Hi everyone, I'm Jeremy Reeves, head blender of Cornell and Diehl Pipe Tobacco Company, and today I want to talk with everyone about an offering we're bringing back after 3 long years without it during our spooky season, The Haunting from Warped. Kyle Gellis and I, how long ago was it? I think 2018 was when the first time that we put The Haunting together. We met and decided kind of the direction that we wanted this blend to go. We wanted to really showcase Virginia tobacco because he was really interested in Virginia pipe tobacco, but we also wanted to pay homage to how he had come up in the premium tobacco world with cigars. And we found this beautiful AA Dominican leaf and a really nice selection of red Virginias and just a touch of cigar leaf Black Cavendish that kind of worked to bridge the gap between the flavor profiles of these two things. So you've got deep red Virginia with a fair amount of nicotine, but also a nice sweetness, a touch of tartness or tanginess. Then this sort of processed cigar leaf that has soft round edges and adds just a little bit of body to the smoke. And then you've got this lovely earthy Dominican leaf that has notes of baking spices, and especially that I always get a touch of cinnamon off of this stuff. And we put this together and, you know, found proportions that worked, and I think it's just lovely. So that was the first thing that the first blend that was in the Warped line, actually. And we brought it back a few times, and like I say, it's been 3 years, but we decided it's time to bring her back. So The Haunting, be coming out very, very soon. Look for it during our upcoming spooky month. There are 3,200 tins available, and this time we decided we wanted to do something just a touch different as well. It's been pressed into a cake. So it pressed beautifully as well. I think that you'll notice on the tin note that it is a little more subdued because everything's compacted together right now. But I think when you get into it, you'll find that it takes to flame beautifully, opens up really nicely, and you get a real depth of flavor specifically from that pressing, that fermentation. So let's go ahead and get into it for a second. I love this cigar leaf so much. It is just a touch sweet on its own. But then it gets kicked up just another notch on sweetness with that Virginia. And you can already begin to taste the effects of pressing here and the fermentation that's taking place inside these cakes. The spices are present as before, but more subdued. The sweetness is kicked up. The aroma reminds me of baking spices. It reminds me of just a fine premium cigar. If you are a fan of Virginia blends, if you're a fan of cigar blends, if you're a fan of blends that focus prominently on white burley, I think there's a lot here to enjoy for anyone in any of those groups. If you're interested in venturing into the world of cigars from pipe, or if you're interested in venturing into the world of pipe from cigars, if you're a fan of Warped Cloud Hopper, either the pipe tobacco or the cigar, if you are a fan of mild to medium bodied premium cigars, if you like Cubans, whatever side of the aisle, so to speak, you're coming from, I think that this is one that is worth checking out and can be a nice introduction to, or a nice change of pace for your rotation to. Yeah, check this stuff out. I think it's great. So thanks, everyone. I look forward to hearing what all of you think about it.